Super Jane.
Celebrations of 75 glorious years of India's independence. The Government of India has named the celebrations as Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, Festival of Independence. The High Commission of India in Pretoria and the three consulates decided to have week-long activities focusing on Gandhiji. Gandhiji is the shared legacy of both South Africa and India, and that's the reason of such grand celebrations. In Gandhiji's own words, "It was after I went to South Africa that I became what I am today." It is to make everyone aware, especially the younger generations, to the role of Mahatma, not only in India's freedom struggle, but also in South Africa's, that we organized a Gandhian trail and the screening of the movie, Making of the Mahatma. The movie will throw light on the places we covered during our trail and much more. Our week-long activities will culminate with this screening. The movie, directed by Shan Penigal, is based on a book by Fatima Mir, The Apprenticeship of a Mahatma. Without further ado, I would like to invite Consul General Ms. Anju Ranjan to say a few words. Madam.
Thank you, Tara. You have already briefed that what we have done. As you know that we started with our legendary celebration on 2nd October, right on the 152 birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. We did the garlanding at Constituent Hill, followed by Tolstoy Farm. High Commissioner joined us at the Tolstoy Farm. I'm thankful to the MGRO, Mahatma Gandhi Remembrance Organization, and Mohan Hira Bhai, Prema Naidoo Sir, and many others who made that celebration very, very special. We also planted some tree over there. Then we had vegetarian food festival there. We had a Gandhi walk of 5 kilometers coming up to the railway line and then going back. And I'm most thankful to the weather, because that stayed on our side. The next day was the trail, which was named as Gandhian Trail, Tolstoy to Phoenix. And as you all must, many of you had gone with us on the trail, you must have seen the magic of Mahatma Gandhi along the way. We started from Tolstoy Farm, we started from the consulate, and then we went to Pietermaritzburg, where Mahatma Gandhi was evicted from the train in 1910. And after that, he became Mahatma, as Nelson Mandela says, "You gave us Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi and we returned you back Mahatma." So that is the one incident changed his life. After that, we went to the Phoenix Farm and received by the legendary, the granddaughter of Mahatma Gandhi, Ila Gandhi. And we had a nice program over there. The black community, the Indian community, everybody participated in the program. We planted some tree and we donated some computer. And after that, our trail continued to Ladysmith, where Mahatma Gandhi was the stretcher bearer during the Boer War. Then we went to Dundee, where he participated and he laid the miners' strike. And then Walcrest, where he was arrested and kept in a 9-month imprisonment. That is also a very interesting story, that magistrate asked him to pay some fine or the imprisonment of 9-month rigorous labor. So he chose the second, because he felt that it was not It was always correct to stand at the side of the victim, and he didn't do anything wrong. So the life lesson what we have seen in the trail will be elaborated in the film today, written by Fatima Mir. And we have with us Prema Naidoo sir, whose grandfather was the right-hand man of Mahatma Gandhi, and who witnessed living with him in Tolstoy Farm and leading the movement by Gandhiji from the front. So before that, I speak so much, it is more important that we hear from his mouth what he feel about this celebration and how Mahatma Gandhi changed the shape of both Africa, South Africa and India. I want to invite Prema Naidoo sir to come and then say a few words about this film, if possible, and the legacy of Mahatma Gandhi carried out by his own family. Please welcome Prema Naidoo sir.
Thank you very much for that introduction. The Consul General from India, Ranjan, Mr. Moosa, let me acknowledge you. Mohan, Hira, the founding member of the Gandhi Remembrance Committee. And let me greet you all, one and all. Good evening, friends, relatives, and comrades. There are two important celebrations here tonight. One, we celebrate in the birth of an icon, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. When Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi came to South Africa as a young lawyer, he came here to defend his clients, the Abdullah family. And it was during that period that he came across one Mr. Thambi Naidoo, who was my grandfather, who the Consul General has spoken about. And as Nelson Mandela said in India, you gave us Gandhiji, we gave you a Mahatma. So Gandhi learned his politics here. And it's a very important lesson that he learned, which he took to India, and he continued the struggle in India against British colonialism. So we're also celebrating the 75th year of independence of India. India was a British colony. India was the first country to be liberated from the cudgels of British colonialism. I don't have to speak, and I'm sure many of you know, how the British plundered India. It is said, I'm not too sure how true it is, that the crown jewels were plundered from India. They ruled India for many years, for probably over 200 years. They ruled India. They plundered it. And there was a very powerful movement that fought against the British colonialists. And that movement, where Gandhi played an important role as a spiritual leader, a leader who believed in honesty, a leader who believed in satyagraha, a leader who believed in non-violence, and a leader who believed in action. Then there were other leaders of the Indian movement. Jawaharlal Nehru, one of the greatest intellectuals of the time, contributed immensely towards the writing of the Indian constitution. Then you had Maulana Kalam Azad, who played an important role in writing of the Indian constitution. Then you also had militants in India who paid the ultimate price for the liberation of India. People like Bhagat Singh, who was executed by the British. The British in Jallianwalabad conducted a massacre. They killed hundreds of Indians who were protesting against the British colonialists. So we must remember there were many people that took part in the struggle. There was a great Indian leader by the name of Sarojini Naidu who came to South Africa. She too took part in the labor. Then there was Vijayalakshmi, who represented India at the United Nations. She made a speech at the United Nations attacking the racist attitude in South Africa. India played an amazing role in the support of the African National Congress and the liberation movement in South Africa. Our representative in India, that was the ANC representative, Mr. Mosi Mulla, was accorded full diplomatic status and he was highly recognized. Many of the ANC leaders were in exile. They went in exile, they couldn't get South African passports to travel. So it is the Indian government that gave them documents to travel. People like Mosi Mulla, Indres Naidoo, my brother Shan, Ramni Naidoo, they all had Indian travel documents. So ladies and gentlemen, while we celebrate India's 75 years of independence, and in that 75 years, they've made remarkable progress. India is on the cusp of a great economic boom. Its economy is set to rise in double digits. So for businessmen who are thinking of an opportunity, there is something that you can look at. So while we look at the great achievements that India made, we mustn't forget the people who contributed towards the building of this great nation, India. With those few words, let me thank the Consul General, let me thank Tara, and all those who are involved for according me this opportunity to say a few words. Thank you very much. I ask you to call Mohan Hira together.
Thank you, everybody. First of all, I'd like to thank our High Commission, our Consulate General for inviting me, and Taravan, and also Mr. Moosa for awarding this opportunity. Prema and I, Prema, we are old friends. I thank you. I'd like to thank everybody for supporting our initiative. It is 75 years of our independent India independence. I also came in 1947 to South Africa. Also, only thing that I came in March, and independence was handed in August. So I missed that opportunity. When we were small, we used to sing Vande Mataram, Jai Hind, Bharat Mata Ki Jai. Then we also used to say Vande Mataram, Thode Din Mein Gandhi Raj. That's what we used to say in those days. So that's how I was. My family was also a member of Subhash Chandra Bose Army. My mama, my uncle, they were militant. And they were arrested in front of me in 1945. So that's how it is. That's our legacy. But me, I am Gandhi follower. And I'm trying to get this process farm going. I promise everybody, when I walk to Durban, and it's about three times that I will get it closer if I'm going. And that is what I'm here for. I hope everybody supports me. And I'd like to thank our Consulate General for supporting this woman. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Hira Bhai, for your kind words. He's a true Gandhian, and he is dedicated to rebuilding the Toaster Farm. I would now like to invite Mr. A.B. Moosa, CEO of the Avalon Group. Co-founded in 1939 by late A.B. Moosa Sr., the Avalon Group is South Africa's oldest and largest independent cinema exhibition and entertainment company. The group was selected in the recent years as one of South Africa's top three film and entertainment companies. Mr. A.B. Moosa has always been forthcoming in providing this theater to the consulate for screening of various movies. Many of you may not be aware that AB's great-grandfather, Dada Abdullah, was the one who invited Gandhiji to South Africa to fight this case, to his case. The character of Dada Abdullah will also feature in the movie. Ms. Moosa, may I now invite you to say a few words.
Thank you. It's always hard to speak last when you have such an illustrious panel speaking before me, but all protocols observed. I certainly won't be too long, but other than to say that, as Tara pointed out, it was my paternal forebears that were responsible for bringing Mahatma Gandhi to South Africa, and that has shaped a lot of our ethos in terms of how we engage not just in terms of our business, but in terms of ensuring we honor his legacy and the values that he espoused. As many of you probably know, that the word Congress in the African National Congress actually comes from the Indian Congress. It was the NIC that was formed prior to the ANC. And John Dubey and Gandhiji had shared ideologies on liberation. And so South Africa's indebtedness to the ideology of the Gandhian philosophy starts from the inception of the ANC. I had the pleasure of being on set when Shan Banigal was here, and we worked closely with him for this production, and obviously had the pleasure of knowing late Fatima Mir, on whose book this story is based. And so for us, and for me, it is an honor to continue with the legacy of those before us, and that it is important to ensure that we continue to record in audiovisual forms and other forms the important lessons and legacies that were left for us as we continue. Especially, I think that the Gandhian values and philosophies are so important in the world we live in today. You know, Martin Luther King said, we live in a world of guided missiles and misguided men. And I think we're going through that whole catharsis even in our country now as well. So we hope that when we see this type of content and we reflect on the Gandhian ideology, it hopefully restores in us the important values and principles that should be espoused. So other than that, there's nothing more for me to say, that we were delighted to partner with the Consul General and the Indian Consulate in Johannesburg for a series of screenings to mark the 75th anniversary, with the culmination of this one being here tonight. So congratulations on a wonderful effort in recognizing this important part of the South Africa-India Connect, and also in the 75th anniversary of India's independence. So thank you very much for coming as well. If I can also ask everyone to switch off your phones or place them on silent when the movie starts. Thank you. Oh yeah, I can ask you, is Shan Moodley here? Yeah, please come. Please come.
In 1996, when this movie was being made, I was a rookie movie maker. And thanks to people like Shan Banigal, who was then the director, Fatima Mir, who was a writer and also one of the producers and announcing, I couldn't have got a better film education had I gone to any university. So in a way, the making of a Mahatma is also making of Shan Moodley. Now, I don't know whether you told them about what the movie's about. So I'm not going to go too much detail. Okay. By today's standards, the movie then was made on a shoestring. But it was the genius of Ashok Mehta, who was the DOP at the time, and he was from India, that director Shan Banigal brought along. It was their combined genius that made the film look more like an epic than a cheap movie. And it is that I recall very vividly, of how through their eyes they were able to do things at that time with limited technology to make the movie look so good. The movie itself records 21 years that Mahatma Gandhi spent in South Africa. You know, he came here on a legal matter for Dada Abdullah. And once that matter was resolved, he stayed on. He met people like Tamil Naidoo, and he was so impressed with the work that they were doing in the struggle against the then colonial governments, that he stayed on for a total of 21 years. It was during this time that he met Tamil Naidoo, Velyamma, who I call the child woman, who sacrificed her life at age 16 when she was imprisoned in Pietermaritzburg, when she got pneumonia. and died a few days after she was released at the age 16 on her birthday. And when Mahatma Gandhi visited her on a deathbed, he was so impressed, and it is reported, how far this is true I do not know, that he designed the flag of India with the same colors that William O. wore. You know, Gandhi started his satyagraha concept and movement at Tolstoy Farm. And in his own words, he said, "I was born in India, but South Africa made me." And it is this belief in satyagraha, which we commonly call passive resistance, that he was able to use against the might of the British government in bringing them down and getting independence in 1947. It is important that we remember our heroes, because unfortunately today, if you go to an average school kid, an Indian school kid, and ask, "What do you know about your forebears in the struggle?" They don't know. They cannot defend that we rightfully, proudly earn our citizenship in this country. It was not given to us on a plate. We fought for it. We worked hard for it. And the contributions we made since then is incorporated in two of the movies that I am going to be involved in. And one is called The Cane Cutter, which is spans over three generations, a love story. And the contribution of Indian South Africans is recorded in there. The other is a movie by the name of Velyamma, and Sharda Ramnathan is going to be the director of that movie. Now, those movies will be made in South Africa with your help. Without any further ado, what I want to say now is, enjoy the making of a Mahatma. Thank you.
Special thanks to SABC, who are one of the co-producers and have supplied the movie. Special thanks to our own AB for providing the hall, the theater. And a big thank you to all of you who have taken time out of your busy schedule to join us to watch the movie. Let us now all enjoy the movie, The Making of the Mahatma.
Super Jane, the weekend we go.
Live every Saturday, 2 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 7 to 10 p.m. UK time, 8 to 11 p.m. SA time.
Across the world, from round your corner.
Super Jane's Weekend Wiggle
is streaming now.